The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily represent those of Access Fort Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting group. Get involved with Access Fort Wayne and make your own television programming. Call 421-1250 to find out more.
Hello and welcome to the Fort Report. I'm Kevin Leininger, News-Sentinel columnist and reporter. With me today is Dan O'Connell, president and CEO of Visit Fort Wayne. Dan, welcome.
Glad to be here, Kevin.
Dan is, I guess, what, Mr. Tourism in Fort Wayne, and it's been a while since you and I have sat down and talked. But if you've been following the news over the last week or two, you've noticed that we have one for sure, I think another one definitely in the pipeline, and a third maybe, new hotel coming to Fort Wayne. So that normally indicates there's something going on with tourism activities. So Dan, better than probably anybody in town, is qualified to tell us what's going on and why. So Dan, before we get to the nitty-gritty, why don't you give us a little overview of what tourism means to Fort Wayne right now. And I think we have a slide that would indicate that as well.
Yeah, tourism is an important part of our local economy. We're not Fort Lauderdale, we understand that, but visitors leave a tremendous economic impact in our city and in our county's economy. About $560 million a year, Kevin, are spent by people visiting Fort Wayne. They need the services that they don't get at home. They stay in hotels, they have to eat at restaurants, they do shopping. And a lot of those people also are here for functions. They're here for sports tournaments, conventions, meetings. They're here to conduct business by visiting the business community. So it isn't all tourism. That group is a segment called leisure visitors. Right. But we get about 1.2 million leisure visitors a year and about 5 million total. And henceforth, that's why the hospitality industry is a big contributor to our local economy in terms of jobs. Over 9,000 jobs are related to that traffic.
Well, and that 500+ million spent, you mentioned, translates into tax revenue as well. About $30 million a year, I think.
Significant amount of money, right?
And they talking hotel, motel tax, restaurant,
hotel, and a little bit of property taxes is in that calculation too. As they pay the businesses that are in hospitality industries pay property taxes locally
and
too.
Other sales taxes as well.
Yes. So,
and we'll get to that maybe in a little more detail later because there are other implications on that. But a lot of what you just went through doesn't happen unless somebody goes out and invites them to come to Fort Wayne, which is really what you do.
That's our agency's purpose. As a not-for-profit organization, our mission is to conduct sales and marketing programs that attract visitors for all sorts of reasons. We certainly try to fill the convention center. We use the Coliseum as a real anchor for people to come in and see concerts and shows and consumer shows. We market the zoo and the tin caps and the festivals. So we try to get people to come here and spend money, and we've been very successful over the last 15 to 20 years that I have been here because the community has built some of the best attractions and buildings there are in the Midwest.
Now, what is your budget right now?
It's $1.5 million.
And the source of your revenue, I know you get some...
80% of our money comes from the tax that is paid by visitors when they stay at a hotel room.
And that's 7%, I believe, right
the
now,
The levy
correct?
Is 7%. Right. We get a couple percentage points. The other major section of that money goes to pay the debt on the Grand Wayne Center and operate that building as one of the major anchors and reasons to visit our community.
Well, you have just produced a new video, one of many you've done over the years, but why don't we go ahead and cue that up if we could, and I think it will give people a little bit of a flavor of what Fort Wayne has to offer and how you're out there trying to let people know about it.
It's a joint project between Punch Films, Parkview Hospital, the YNLI group, and we help put together a lifestyle video of what it's like a year in Fort Wayne of all the things that are going on.
Okay, well, if we could run that, why don't we do that?
Thank you.
tumbleweeds slowly moving on, on, on. So shoot it down, shoot it back till it's fine, to your place, shiver. It doesn't matter now, doesn't matter now, 'cause I've got myself set forward upon your sea.
Well, that was very well done, and really made Fort Wayne look almost cool. That isn't something, a word a lot of us who have lived here all our lives, you know, used to use for the city we love and grew up in. Is that good marketing, or is Fort Wayne really in danger of becoming, you know, kind of a place people want to be, especially the young?
No, Fort Wayne's a very happening place, very happening. There's so much going on in all sorts of sectors. The arts community is blossoming, the sports community is blossoming, but along with that is the millennial and the desire to try to attract more millennials as key employees for the future. Mm-hmm. We're starting to create a lot of buzz around our restaurant community, mm-hmm. around our music industry, our entertainment, street entertainment. So it's becoming really hip town, if it's an old term from the 70s.
Especially in the downtown, right?
Because of people wanting to have a lifestyle that's exciting and individualistic and has involved the arts, mm-hmm. more than just let's go to the zoo. The zoo is still a wonderful attraction, actually a very high experience ratings at every time people go there, mm-hmm. but it's just one now of many choices of things to do in our city.
Well, when you put a video like that together, or any of your marketing options, do you try to determine what will attract people here, or do you respond to a demand that is already known? In other words, do you invent the demand, or do you respond to it?
No, a little bit of both. There are definite tourism trends of what the consuming public out there are looking for. And we know that the millennials are looking for unique experiences. Mm-hmm. So we put this video together to show a lot of the neat, unique experiences in our community. Mm-hmm. We know we're a good family destination. That's what fits our brand. So also in that video, we have a lot of family shots of families picnicking, right. walking through the zoo, and enjoying the parade or a ball game. Those are things that fit our niche. So we're after families, but we're also after that market where we're trying to entertain people that we're not just a stoic, historic fort, that there's a lot of fun stuff to do here.
Now, where would you show that video? Who would be able to see that?
It's beautifully done, so we can use it on the internet, mm-hmm. and we have on our website, but it's also on the Greater Fort Wayne Inc.'s website. It's also on part of Northeast Partnerships website. We also have used it several times when we lead into bidding on a convention. Mm-hmm. You know, you're standing before a delegation board of 15 or 20 people, sometimes hundreds if you're in front of a group, and we show the video to demonstrate what Fort Wayne looks like and what they could experience if they came there.
Now, that's probably too long to advertise on TV for other markets, but I know you do some of that as well, too, correct?
Well, we'll take slices of this and turn it into 30-second commercials, use the B-roll, if you will, and kind of use that to help emphasize things like special promotions we do with Savor Fort Wayne or the summer festivals and things like that.
Now, where do you draw people from? I'm sure you track response. Is it Northeast Indiana, the Midwest, or even broader than that?
What we find is people come in here about 150 miles away. That's our tourist, the person who's going to come in and probably stay overnight. So we try to market in those cities that are 150 miles away. So we put money into Grand Rapids, beyond Lima, Ohio, certainly in the Indianapolis market, and a lot of Northwestern Indiana. inside that market circle, that donut, if you will, we do a lot of promotion in much smaller radio stations, newspapers, mm-hmm. by public relations. We don't really buy a lot of airtime. One example is we'll trade out tickets for the Tin Caps or a special performance at the Embassy Theater for a radio station that might be in Logansport. Then they'll do a promotion like, hey, why don't you come in mm-hmm. Fort Wayne and see this performer this weekend and stay over and have a good time in Fort Wayne. And that's a contest they'll run on their website. So we do great amount of collaborative work and get earned media using tickets from the Coliseum, the Embassy Theater, Tin Caps, the Zoo, put them in packages, run website contests, and all along that we're running this video and other things on their websites too, so they can see, hey, that looks like a happening place, let's go there.
And people from Indianapolis actually do visit Fort Wayne.
They
as,
do.
As much as we do, maybe not. But
we talk on our radio morning show. I know that Whoa often does
right.
Here is that, let's go to Indy and do this, or that's happening. And some, we do the same thing in their markets.
Well, and even the Chicago, I think it was the Tribune, a few months ago had a very nice piece about mm-hmm. how happening Fort Wayne actually is. And it, surprisingly enough, was not all that condescending. It was pretty genuine, I think.
And maybe your audience doesn't understand that those are cultivated articles. Mm-hmm. You talk to the writer, you get on their future writing storylines, and you kind of convince them to do something. And this year, we've had a record number of writers, bloggers, articles come into Fort Wayne and write stories in their own travel publications or their own travel blogs. And we've had over 30 different publications go out and talk about visiting Fort Wayne as a destination. We talk to 30 million people a year.
And you can't really do that if you don't have something legitimate to offer, correct? Because if you invite them in and you don't deliver, then you get a bad story.
Exactly.
Perhaps.
But when you find that the Tin Caps is the best minor league experience in America, mm-hmm. and that's voted several years running, when you get exit interviews with people from the Zoo and they're rating it 9 out of 10, mm-hmm. the average is 9, you have good product and you have good customer satisfaction. We're finding that also with our hotel and hospitality community. They're being very responsive to visitors.
Well, I'm guessing the trend is bigger and better upward over the last several years, correct?
The last couple of years, the state average for the economy of tourism has been up about 2%. You know, it's on the steady, nice growth since the recession.
And are we keeping up with that?
We're at
4. So we're better.
We're at twice.
Other than you all doing a great job at Visit Fort Wayne, what do you attribute that to?
I think it attributes to a couple of things. The investment the community's made in the downtown has helped a lot. The ballpark would be start of it, but the business community has responded by building J.K. O'Donnell's and Ash Center, and so we're very clean and hospitable downtown. I think the second thing is that we've had a lot of investment in sports tourism, and that's brought a lot of people to Fort Wayne to watch Johnny play basketball at Spieth or to have a volleyball tournament, and that's helped generate people right. who are aware of Fort Wayne because they're coming with their
and
kids.
And we have the new ice
and they come
facility.
Back, right, the ice center. So I think organized functions have brought people to town. The other thing is, I think, Kevin, is there a lot of people want Fort Wayne to be good, to do well, to be proud of it. And I sense people working at that by improving their storefronts, by working with us. They come in and say, you know, I got an opportunity to bring the Scrabble Convention to town. You want to help me? Or I belong to the National Brass Band Association. Can you work with us? Mm-hmm. And the art community, the Embassy Theater, the universities are all trying to make Fort Wayne a better place to live and work. And we see that as an opportunity to make Fort Wayne a better place to visit as well.
And when they visit, they need a place to stay, obviously, which gets us back to the hotel issue I mentioned at yep. the top of the show. I think an exciting announcement a week or so ago was the Providence, quote-unquote, boutique hotel
yes.
being planned for downtown, probably on Harrison Street somewhere, although we don't know for sure, about a $27 million project. At least up to now, it looks like it was mostly privately begun, largely privately funded. There will be some public component to that. But Barbara Backgard, co-founder of Vera Bradley, was the driving force behind it, which is really something, I think, unique to Fort Wayne. What will having a hotel like that in the heart of downtown mean, do you think?
Well, it's a tremendous opportunity for our destination. Just as you indicated, what's making us a good place. Barb wants to make us an even better place. And so she's proud to make a signature hotel investment in our community. And I think that's wonderful for our opportunity of getting it beyond the synergy of public funding, just trying to get some things going, that now there's a little snowballing going on, and her new investment will be a 120-room property by a very established hotel partner in Providence, and I think it's going to raise the bar. I've talked to some of the hotel community, and they don't see this as competition. They see it as a great opportunity to help showcase our community, and so they're very proud of the fact that their hotel industry is getting a jewel of a product coming in.
Well, and White Lodging is looking at building another one down by the ballpark. They already operate Courtyard by Marriott, which would be another 120-room, give or take, facility. So we would have four downtown, and there's always talk of maybe something down closer to the riverfront, ultimately. We don't know about that yet. So our clearly that will expand our ability, especially if we do the arena downtown as well, to attract bigger conventions, bigger trade shows downtown as well.
Right there, the White Lodging property, people own Courtyard, have had a right on a piece of land adjacent to them ever since they originally developed. But the economy has been strong, and our business industry has been strong around Fort Wayne, that now's the time that they think they want to invest in a property and build a bigger hotel product there. So they're talking to the city. There's also hotels up north by the DuPont Hospital, Parkview Hospital area, because of that interchange is being developed, very common location for hotels, as we know.
And Parkview is a magnet.
Yeah, people generator. That's what they like to be by, because they're in the business of selling rooms and overnight stays. So hospitals, growing northern suburb, a new interchange, has a couple of properties looking up there.
Of course, new hotels generate new revenue. We talked about the tax before. Now, I know there is a move afoot to increase that to a degree. I think you've been pushing Visit Fort Wayne, a 1% increase. Some people think it should go even more than that, maybe up to 10%, which is what I think Indianapolis is right now.
Right.
And of course, all of that could help pay for, not only the arena, but a lot of other projects that are being talked about right now. What are your thoughts on that? I mean, is there a saturation point that you can't go above, or have we not reached that yet?
Well, our board is advocating a 1% increase because of these three reasons. One is it hasn't been increased in 10 years, and it isn't because it hasn't been increased, we want to increase it. It's because so much has changed in Fort Wayne in 10 years. The convention center expanded. You just talked about another hotel coming on. We moved the ballpark downtown. The Coliseum has expanded twice. Mm-hmm. We've added other attractions and amenities. So there's a demand there to really fill in more marketing. Two is we're really not reaching out as far as we need to. I talked about it 100, 150 miles. It could be 300. We could do a much better job because we have that quality of product and destination. So we want to do that. So that's the second reason we have it. And we have a plan to work with Turnstone on a very niche market of helping Fort Wayne be known for adaptive sporting events.
Right, out of their field house.
And that isn't being marketed right now. And we feel that's a need where some new resources would do it. So the hotel community has agreed with all that and have supported our case for making a 1% increase on that hotel tax. And so has the Greater Fort Wayne Inc.'s Northeast Indiana Partnership, a couple other groups like Turnstone, and we'll be appealing it to the legislature this fall. They're the ones with the authority that can raise that tax.
Now, the 1% would go to Visit Fort Wayne, right?
For the sales and marketing.
If they would do anything above that, then there's talk of would it go to the arena project?
It has been suggested that if you're going to go through that work, which is to get everybody lined up and supporting it and go to the legislature, maybe you should just go.
You don't want to do it every year.
Right? Well, it hasn't been done in 10 years.
Right.
Our feeling is twofold on that, Kevin. One is we have a need for the 1% right now. The 2% is something we can go back to in the future if and when the arena becomes a reality. I think there's a few more hurdles that has to go through. I think there are some few more questions of what needs to be financed, how much. Mm-hmm. There's always an opportunity to go back for the hotel tax in the future. Right now, you're just putting a little bit of the cart before the horse. Mm-hmm. I've also talked to some legislators, and they have cautioned us, saying, has the community voted in favor of this arena project? Is there other financing models? What's the total bill? All those questions need to be answered, and they're not answered yet, so the timing is a little bit off. Yeah. We'll go for 1% now and probably go back in the future if need be, if there aren't other financing tools.
Well, it is a little bit of a chicken and the egg, isn't
yes.
it? Because it's hard to commit to a project if you don't have the funding stream, but the state might be reluctant to give you the funding stream if you don't have widespread support for the project.
And some details that they don't really right know, and that's the delegation that's telling us. Well, mm-hmm. give us something we can help you with, but don't come and look like a money grab and the whole thing's going to fall apart.
Right, because they still haven't determined whether right. they want to do it, number one, and who would manage it.
And being a couple yeah. percentage points in tax below Indy is a good marketing position
bad, yeah.
for us.
Have you and the organization determined any position on the arena yet?
We have not. We're watching it like a lot of people are waiting. The design is just being flushed out now. Mm-hmm. The financing tools have not been determined. I think they've pretty much determined the location. So we're very close to that. We're mm-hmm. talking to the powers that be who are analyzing and studying it. But I just don't think that we're really in a position to say yes or no yet. And I don't know if we ever will, Kevin, because it's a scenario that our assignment as the marketing organization is to fill what's been built. Mm-hmm. You build a ballpark downtown, we're going to try to fill it. You build a new music festival, we're going to try to champion and promote it. So the arena is a situation where I think where people have to decide what to do and what to do and how to pay for it. And when they do, we'll be 100% behind it. But I don't know, our vote's going to really thumb up or thumb down.
No, and you don't have a feel or a yeah. position on whether it would attract more people to town at this point.
I don't, not right now. It's a tool. Arena is a lot of local involvement. It's got your basketball teams in it. It's got local concerts that people go to. Certainly it would draw some people across the county line.
Right.
But whether that is becomes a real anchor for our hospitality industry is yet to be seen.
Well, and the determination to what degree, if any, it would compete with the Embassy and the Coliseum. And if it did, how do you make them whole as something else financially?
And those are some of the questions that you're saying that there are legislators saying may not go for a tax increase now because you haven't answered some of those questions. What's the total impact on the community?
Well, I know you have a couple things coming up that are pretty exciting. Why don't we talk a little bit about Taste of Fort Wayne?
Well, we have a promotion each January 11th through the 22nd this year called Savor Fort Wayne. It's Visit Fort Wayne's opportunity to try to champion the homegrown, home-owned restaurants in our community. We have some fabulous ones. We said earlier about what's making us dynamic. We have some great restaurants coming into our community, coming online, and some that have been here for many, many years. And so we use that 2 weeks in January to create special menu items where people can get three different entrees in one $30 price. That's what it costs, $30. So if people can go to Eddie Merlot's, they can go to Hall's, they can go to Casa's, they can go some of the very favorite ones that they've gone to, or they can try. Now we have over 41 restaurants this year. Last year we had 30, we have 41 right now, and so it's a great opportunity.
So people
to get
are really eager to participate.
Taste Fort Wayne, like you said, but we call it Savor Fort Wayne because it's really an opportunity to get out with your friends and family in the middle of winter when it's a rough time and enjoy yourselves.
Well, and the ones I've been to as part of that promotion, you really do more than taste, you do savor.
Yeah.
So the topic and the title is very good. You've got a really neat feature on your website, and before we forget, why don't you give that? What is the web address?
Our website is visitfortwayne.com, and it's a very popular website. We have over 1 million unique visitors a year, over 2.5 million page views per year. It's a very comprehensive website that has information about Fort Wayne, what's there to see and do here, including things we call 360 videos. Mm-hmm. Over 60 different videos are linked together so people can try and see by visually what's happening inside Science Central. What's it look like at the zoo? What's the Grand Wayne Center look like if we're going to meet there for a convention? So these are all visually laid out in a kind of aerial view map of Fort Wayne where you can kind of drill down with your telephone or your laptop or your mobile device as well as your computer and tour the zoo and some
right.
of
I mean, you
attractions.
Can really actually click on
yes.
a destination you want to see, and then you'll get a close-up not only externally, but also you can take a walk through the Coliseum or the Grand Wayne.
And these are available right on people's phones at visitfortwayne.com. We're retooling some of the attractions right now, so we're not everybody be up, but we're that's what we're doing.
And you really, I think, are a pioneer in this. It's been done to some degree other places, but I think I'm correct, and this is one of the more detailed kind of high-tech?
It is. Two things. It used to be kind of used when real estate agents were selling houses. You could kind of see it, but it's been embedded now. It has products that you can click inside the video and see other videos. You can see pictures. You can bring up other websites. So it's very conducive to pitching a destination. And right now, there's some cities in Arizona and Florida that are using it. We're probably the largest population in the Midwest that are using it.
Do you ever worry that if you do too good a job of virtual tours, people won't actually come?
Yeah, well, they've always said that. High tech often generates high touch. That's what happens when people see what they're experiencing. And nowadays, 80% of all population uses a website, looks at customer reviews. We talked about what some of the trends in tourism is. They want to see the thing. They almost want to taste it before they're going to try the product. But it often entices them to want to see more. That's really what it is. So it's producing an interest more than saying, okay, I've done that.
Well, we only have a couple of minutes left. The time's really flown by. But we've talked about everything going well. Do you have any challenges or anything you need to do a better job other than more money always?
Well,
helps.
That's always the task. I think there's a couple of things. One is we find that the image of Fort Wayne sometimes isn't as well known as how good the product is here, whether it's the genealogy library or zoo or the ballpark. And so we really see and try to convince our civic leaders that it's about marketing, it's about promotion. You really have to get the message out there. They just don't know. So we find that as a problem, or you should say a need. We really do have to promote Fort Wayne more than it's being done. So, and that takes resources. I think is to be vigilant about hospitality. Hoosier Hospitality really works for us. You should see the love letters we get from people who have been here for conferences or tournaments or at the visitor center. It really does work for our destination. So we're always trying to ensure that our front desk employees and people working, they're proud of their city and they're really armed with information to talk to visitors about it. And I think the third one thing that might be is that, you know, the riverfront's a real opportunity. It's a real opportunity to be a game changer for us. I hope we stay on top of that project, and in the next 10 years instead of 30 or something like that, we really have a product that will showcase our community.
Well, if done right, that really could be a regional draw.
It really could be a real asset for not only the quality of life, but making us a destination to come visit to.
Okay. Well, Dan O'Connell, thank you very much for being with us on the Fort Report, and thank you all for joining us as well. Hopefully we can have Dan back in another year or two and talk about how the new riverfront development is working, bringing more people downtown. So again, I'm Kevin Leininger. Be sure to check this and other episodes out at www.news-sentinel.com. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.